Everyone, I'm Vikram Salunke and welcome to the Web Application Penetration Testing and Secure Coding. In the last video, we analyzed the HTTP request sent by the web browser to the web server. Now, in this video, we'll analyze the response coming back from web server to the web browser. So, let's get started. Your Kali machine once again. In the location bar, type vulnerable.app. It is saying connecting. That means our request is currently into the burp. We'll go to the burp. The request is going to vulnerable.app. These are the request header which we saw in the last video. We'll click on the forward, and now the request has reached to the web server and web server sent the response back. This is the response back from the web server, and these are some new HTTP response header, and now let's analyze those. Now let's look at our connection once again. This is our Firefox web browser. This is our vulnerable.app web server, and we have configured our burp proxy to listen to our connection. When we type vulnerable.app into the web browser, the request goes to the burp first. After that, when we click the forward, the request will go to the web server, and then web server will send the response, and it will come to the burp proxy first. After that, when we click on the forward, that response will go to the web browser. In the last video, we saw the HTTP request headers. Now in this video, we see the HTTP response header coming back from web server to the web browser. Let's look at the format of a HTTP message once again. First, there are the headers. After that, there is a blank line. And after that, the message body. And this remains same for the HTTP request as well as for HTTP response. This is the HTTP request which we saw in the last video. And for that request, web server sent the HTTP response. Let's analyze the HTTP response. First, there is HTTP 1.1200 OK. After that, date. Then server. Then vary. After that, content length. After that, connection close, and then content type, and after that, the actual page content. Now let's analyze this HTTP response line by line. First, there is HTTP 1.1200 OK. As we saw in the last video, the browser was communicating on HTTP 1.1 version, and same has been sent by the web server. After that, there is a 200 OK. 200 is a status code, and OK is that status code's meaning. 200 OK status code means the request has been successful. Such as the status code start with the 1 are the informational ones. The status code which starts with the 2s are success ones. And in this case, we saw the 200 OK. The status code which starts with the 3s are redirectional one. And most common is 301 moved permanently. The status codes which starts with the 4 are known as a client error, and the most common is 404 not found. So if the resource is not available to that web server, it sends the status code 404 not found. The status codes which starts with the 5s are known as the server errors, and the most common is a 500 internal server error. Now each of these status codes we will look in detail in upcoming videos. Next HTTP response is date. That means it is a date and a time of a message created. Next HTTP response is a server. The value for this HTTP response header is Apache 2.429 Debian. That means it is a web server banner. Different web server has different banners. In this case, the web server is Apache. That's why this banner, if there is some different web server, then the banner will be different. Next is accept encoding, and as we saw in the last video, the encoding information was sent by the browser, and this response is generated based on the accept encoding. Next is a content length. This length is a message body length in a bytes. Next is a connection close. That means we are closing this connection, and for the new request, the new connection will be made. Next is a content type. It is telling about the type of a message body. In this case, the type of a message body is HTML. At some cases, it might be some other format such as PDF, etc. Now, in this case, these are the HTTP response headers. After that, there was one empty line, and this is the actual message body of a HTTP response. This is the actual content which we see in a web browser. Okay, so this is our HTTP response which we got from the server. HTTP 1.1, then date, server, content length, connection, etc. And then there is actual body of a message. And when we click on the forward, this response will go back to the web browser. Click forward. And as we can see, the response is back to the web browser. Okay, so that's what I had planned for this video. If you have any doubts, any questions, you can contact me on the following handles. Thank you.